I'm not going to mess with Gerald Palmer because from what I understand, he's left me alone. I think Gerald has left me alone. If you left me alone, brother, I wish you well. If you left me alone, I wish you well. If you left me alone, I wish you well. You understand? You don't bother me. I don't bother you. Anybody know Dr. Umar? I don't pick fights. I don't start trouble. Anybody who knows Dr. Umar knows I don't pick fights. I don't start trouble.
Anti-Afro Svengalis, indeed, under pressure. What you heard at the very beginning was a small snippet of Umar Johnson making the claim that he has some sort of power over controlling what people put on their channels. He thinks he can compel or command people to put content that he wants on their channel. He even thinks he has a right to insist that people respond to his perverted ramblings. What Umar Johnson is also trying to convey is a threat. If you don't stop posting videos about me, I will continue making you the subject of my perverted ramblings. So, well, Umar continues to do that. He just creates more evidence. Whether or not any person, whether it's Reverend Gerald Palmer, whoever else, decides whether or not they want to record videos on Umar Johnson's fraud, they can do that. If they don't want to, what does it have to do with what I'm doing on this channel? Nothing. I'm going to continue what I'm doing. And there are many other people out there who are going to say the same thing. Whether someone wants to record a video, it's not relevant to what they're going to do. So it's very lame, weak, and pathetic for Umar to think he can run us off by making threats to continue with his perverted ramblings. We are going to deal with that in a way that Umar Johnson definitely is not going to like, or he doesn't like, because he was coming off the rails when he was referring to it, trying to force people into talking about sex, sexual issues, and indulge in his perverted, disgusting diatribes about sex. None of us are obligated to indulge Umar Johnson's perverted fantasies. Umar Johnson absolutely must and wants to talk about sex on a continuous basis. When people are not going to oblige or respond to him, he gets more riled up, continues to freak out because he wants people talking about this subject. This is actually a form of sexual harassment. If you do not want to talk about sex with someone, the person cannot force you to talk about sex. Umar Johnson continues making up this garbage and finding ways to bring up the topic of sex, in particular, gay sex, LGBT, sexual issues. He continues to force the issue because he must engage in the conversation. He can't force us to post videos about it. When I say us, those of us who are going to be standing strong and holding to our objective of holding Umar Johnson accountable through the legal system, that's what we're going to do. We are not going to sit here and indulge Umar gross, disgusting, nasty fantasies that keep getting more and more bizarre. I will repeat, if Umar Johnson is so hard up to talk about sex and have everybody talking and giving comments about sex and sexual nature and LGBTs, they can all get together and build their own porn channel. But that's not allowed on YouTube. YouTube does not allow porn. And that's what Umar Johnson apparently wants. And his co-idiot flunkies seem to want the same thing. So go right ahead and do that. Leave everybody else out of it, because nobody else is going to indulge that. There are websites where Umar Johnson can go and have at it to his heart's desire. He can go to the gay porn sites. He can go to the lesbian sites. He can go to whatever scenario he wants to make up and He can create his own fantasy. He could try to go on webcams. Why doesn't he go and see if he can get money for a sex webcam or something? We don't want anything to do with that. So Umar Johnson coming up with all of this, it's not going to distract us from what we're doing. If you don't like what's happening on this channel, which I've stated before, you don't have to come here. If somebody wants to continue coming here and trying to leave messages that are going to be just deleted, there's nothing I can do about that. They will, however, need to continue making up screen names because they're going to be blocked. That's it. We are not indulging in Umar Johnson's perverted dialogue. He can have it with himself. He can have it with these co-idiot flunkies. He can go to porn sites. We're not in the porn industry. Umar Johnson desperately wants to be in the porn industry because that's all he talks about. Again, that's Umar Johnson's issue to deal with on one hand. Now, here comes how we do get involved with addressing this issue. We simply send it to those who can evaluate all of these statements and make a decision about whether or not they want Umar Johnson representing the state of Pennsylvania with a credential. Because like I stated, his behavior is sexually harassing. There is an agency within the Department of Ed, where actually it's a subdivision of the Department of Ed. It's called the Professional Standards and Practices Commission. And the jurisdiction, as it states here, is not affected by the status of an educator's certificate, whether it's lapsed or inactive, or by the status or location of current employment, whether the person's retired, they're at a private school, they're out of state working, or even a charter school. They are still under the jurisdiction of the state of Pennsylvania. That's the point you have to keep in mind. Having said that, I'm going to read, or you can see it on the screen, what is an ethical educator? The ethical educator is a person who accepts the requirements of membership in the education profession and acts at all times in ethical ways. In doing so, the ethical educator considers the needs of students, the community, and the profession. Now, you tell me whether or not this is what Umar Johnson is doing. This is going to be the response to all this garbage that Umar Johnson has been spewing and getting more agitated because we don't want to engage him in his disgusting and vile sexual fantasies and ramblings. What is the solution to this issue? There are a couple. I would like to put one forth. Now, if you look at this list here, it is quite comprehensive. As you can see, I have Umar defrocked, which means he does not rank or deserve to be in a profession that he claims he's in. He is hereby defrocked. Children beware, parents beware, and of course, buyer beware. Now, looking at this list, it may seem overwhelming. Believe it or not, these are all the things that Umar Johnson engages in. Using people's names, telling other people to type or to post videos with this subject matter. Umar Johnson has engaged in every single action that you see on the screen. What I was thinking, rather than feel overwhelmed thinking, okay, I've got to address all these issues at once. No, we don't have to address all the issues at once. Here is the strategy. And if I gave a shit whether or not Umar or someone else knew about it, I sure wouldn't be posting it on YouTube. So here is what I'm putting forth. We should all get together and write a complaint individually and focus on the sexual comments that Umar Johnson has made. There's other things going on, but let's bombard the Pennsylvania Department of Ed with Umar Johnson's own words. No one needs to make up anything. We have the videos, just the video that King Kong Crazy has posted, the two videos, that alone would cover it. Umar went on a diatribe, a sexual perverted diatribe during that video. And he's also saying that he's a therapist and a psychologist and whatever, and a principal. And he's making these statements. So let's get the strength lined up and file a complaint focusing exclusively on the sexual comments and the sexual obsessions of Umar Johnson and let the state figure out what they want to do with it. Once that's done, if you already haven't, feel free to go through this list. There are memes, there are videos, there are live streams that were captured where Umar is making statements, stating what he's going to do, and then telling his co-idiot flunkies to do it for him. That's all there in the videos that King Kong Crazy posted. That is plenty to get the Department of Ed churning up even more if they already haven't started. No one can stop us from filing complaints. We're going to stick with the strength. We're not going to be pulled down into the gutter with Umar and his co-idiot flunkies. They are helping us. Don't respond to them because they're getting more angry. They're getting more frustrated. They're getting frantic. They're frenzied that we are not directly responding to them and getting into a discussion with them. Why? That's not going to lead us anywhere. The goal is to make sure Umar Johnson is held accountable. And the way to do that is to alert the officials to simply what is on audio and what is on video. He's making a big deal about something and being angry because people are simply pointing others to what he has said. So him coming on here saying things like, I'm going to leave him alone. I'm going to leave the Reverend Gerald Palmer alone because he's left me alone. So that has nothing to do with people who have decided we're moving forward. If Gerald Palmer wants to record an Umar video, fine. If he does not, that's his business. Umar Johnson trying to dictate and control what people do on their social media accounts. And he is not in any way responsible for managing any social media account. He doesn't own YouTube. He doesn't own Facebook. He doesn't own Instagram. He doesn't own any of that. So the desperation, the frenzy, the freaking out, that is what Umar Johnson is left to do. He's resorting back to what he did when he was much younger. He had all these younger siblings, and imagine what it was like for them. He thinks he can bully us like he bullied his own siblings. That's why you don't hear from any of them. When have you ever heard from any of Umar Johnson's siblings? We are not Umar Johnson's siblings. We have no loyalty to him. We have no respect for him. We don't owe him anything. He does not dictate what we do. Forget it. We are not listening to Umar Johnson's commands. And his illegal behaviors are simply going to be highlighted. Let him explain it to a judge. Let him explain it to the Pennsylvania Department of Ed. And if he is too stupid to recognize that the situation with the Board of Psychology simply set him up for what's to come, again, that is Umar Johnson's problem. It is not our problem, and we should not in any way be concerned about that. He is going to answer for everything that he has said and done, including these last two rants that are downright despicable and disgusting. No person should be anywhere around children who talks like that and acts like that. Listen to what he says, talking about hot women, sexy asses, and give me money for a school. Oh, that's really, really something that's upstanding and respectable. These things have to be shown to the Department of Ed because they are the ones that are going to do what they need to do to address these issues. Getting into a back and forth with these fools, I'm going to repeat it. It isn't worth it. You saw it on King Kong Crazy's live. All of that effort went into thinking they can talk to this person, and she ends up coming for Lennon's children again after denying that she had. Forget it. Who is going to waste their time? Simply highlight the fact that this person is acting at the behest of Umar because she even said it. And all the other flunkies out there who cite Umar Johnson as the reason for doing this and that. This is proof. This is support of his negative influence. And a negative influence has no business being in any sort of leadership position. They shouldn't be responsible for the health and safety of any children. They most certainly can't be running a school. That we don't have to worry about because it will never open. So I'm not giving that attention. In that respect, what will be given attention is the financial malfeasance. But for this complaint to the Department of Ed, focus on the sexual ramblings, the perverted diatribes that Umar is known for. He absolutely must have sex in the equation, but we don't have to have it in the equation. He can go off and do whatever he wants to do at a porn site. We are not engaging in porn on this channel. On this channel, keep in mind there is no pressure. If you want to come along and support this mission, by all means, you're welcome. If you want to come here just to read the comments, if you want to come here for a laugh, if you want to come here as a spectator, nobody's going to harass you for that. The only restriction is no attacking people on this board, which is why I work very hard to make sure none of these freaks put comments. And when they're noticed, everybody's doing a much better job. If the person is let on by accident, most people are ignoring them, and I'll eventually find the comment, or you'll let me know it's there and I will delete it. That is the discipline that we must maintain in order to reach our goal. Don't tolerate this abuse and harassment by Umar Johnson. Let's see what the Board of Education has to say. Now, I have another video coming up. I'm going to be utilizing Umar Johnson's own words and reporting him to the Attorney General again. And I'm going to include the most recent financial malfeasance, and we're adding witness intimidation to that. Stay tuned for that video. I'm working on it. We're simply going to keep reporting. We're not going to roll around with the swine and the pigsty. We don't have time for that. We don't want to be nasty and dirty like Umar Johnson and his co-flunkies are. We want to remain relatively hygienic and appropriate. We are going to have fun in the process, but don't mistake, the goal is very serious and we're going to remain on track. In the meantime, maintain adherence. Buyer, beware.